I don't even know you. You just steal someone's name like that, dude? How dare you? Durag, you are the fake.
Fuck.
Fucking knew it.
What's up, everybody? Durag back at it again with another video on a new game called Warfare 1944. This is a game that is currently being made by BlueDrake42 along with his buddies over at Drakeling Labs. The cool guys over at Blackside decided to give me a key so that I could try it out, and for that, I thank them. Because I gotta say, this is like the most interesting looking World War II game that I had ever actually seen. And it's kind of an achievement coming out from a YouTuber too. Not to say that YouTubers haven't created their own games, but this is the first time I've ever actually seen a tactical-esque game from a rising YouTuber. But yeah, Warfare 1944 is heavily inspired by the old Battlefield 1942 game. But with a bit of a twist, it adds squad mechanics or Project Reality mechanics, whichever is your fancy, to the game sometime in the future. As it stands now, the game is still relatively early, but thanks to the art style, it allows the developers to have damn near perfect optimization. I hopped into one of their games when there was like 64 players, which was the max capacity on the server, and it ran really well. I was actually surprised. Granted, there wasn't any explosions or vehicles moving around, base building, or anything of the sort. And according to some of my subscribers, they might be trying to make the servers up to 100. We'll see what the servers are like as soon as they add in all of that stuff. But for now, at least, it ran pretty well with a full server. They actually give another reason as to why they decided to go with this art style, and that simply has to do with the fact that they can easily make assets for the game, because they don't really have to, you know, make them look in-depth. They just have to make sure that the asset looks the part and functions the way that it's supposed to. So yeah, going with this art style is really a good move for them, and I could definitely back it because the game plays pretty well. Like I actually saw in the shooting range, there was a Kuba wagon and a Willy Jeep, and it actually functioned pretty well. But anyways, there was only two maps that I played. It was Utah Beach and Carentan. I believe they announced another one, but I don't remember what it was. But I think it was on Drake's YouTube channel or something. They were relatively big, but I'm not entirely sure how historically accurate these maps are, but they look World War II enough. Like, to be honest, it really doesn't matter, at least to me anyway. But yeah, the maps are pretty good size for how many people were in the match. They also had like four classes that were featured. There was a grand total of like five guns on each side, with the squad lead getting two weapons. The squad lead on the German side got a MP5 and a Luger. The American side, he got a Thompson and a 1911. I think the next class down, you got a BAR on the American side and a STG on the other side. The rifleman class for the Americans got a M1 Grand, and the German side got a Kar 98, and the class that was at the very bottom for the German side got a Gewehr. I'm not sure if that's how you pronounce that, but yeah. And on the American side, it was a M1 carbine. I think out of all the weapons that I tried, I think my favorite one was the M1 carbine. I felt that it worked the best for me. They are for sure going to add more weapons, but at the timing of this recording, this is all they had. It seems like they really nailed down the reloading animations. I'm not sure if they're going to improve on that, but from where it stands now, the animations look pretty good. And especially with the bolt action guns, they actually do put in the correct amount of bullets when you reload. Now, something that I would like to see is probably maybe like, you know, you being able to check how much ammo you have in the weapon. That would be something cool to see. A bit of criticism for the weapons. The guns felt like they kind of didn't have any feedback. Like I was clicking on the mouse to, you know, fire, but the gun wouldn't like, you know, pull back on me a little bit just to show that I was, you know, releasing a bullet out of the chamber. Like there just wasn't a lot of feedback is what I'm trying to say. Like I wasn't feeling the gun shooting. Like if they could improve on that, then their gameplay is pretty much solid. Another big criticism of the game that I have now as it stands is that the audio felt like it was kind of all over the place. Like my footsteps, they sounded like they were behind me instead of under me. It was a bit confusing trying to listen in to see where the enemy was because my own footsteps would confuse me. Gun sounds sounded like they were a lot closer than they actually were. And yeah, those were like the main ones that I had issues with so far. Everything else is because the game is pretty early. So instead of trying to find all the problems with it, I just want to talk about what I would like to see in the game. So like I said before, I would really like to see vehicles in the game because I wonder how it would actually change up the flow of gameplay. You could see a Willy Jeep and a Kuba wagon in the shooting range right now, but I'm curious to know what that's actually going to be like in combat. You can't destroy them right now, but you could drive around in them. And also, I believe if you're sitting in the passenger seat, you're able to keep your weapon out And basically do like a drive-by, essentially. All the passengers should be able to like shoot while the driver is driving. I would also like to see your characters actually have some other stuff. Like, they showed like a preview of what you get later on down the line, but that stuff's not attached to your guide just yet. You get like a medical kit, a knife, a gun, a grenade for each class for the most part. Your character does heal over time, but you're not able to actually heal yourself. I want there to be a buddying system. Like, you create a squad and you can have people in your squad. I hopped in with a bunch of subscribers and we weren't able to like hook up or anything. It was just kind of like all over the place. I hope that they add like some sort of spawning system so that we can actually, you know, spawn in the general area of where the flag is supposed to be, or make it so that the squads can actually put down some sort of rally system. That'd be nice. I'm curious to know if this game is actually going to have base building. I mean, it would definitely be pretty cool to have fortified areas, because I'm sure taking places like Carentan isn't going to be something that's easy to do. Also, I heard somewhere along the line that they could also do destruction of buildings and stuff. And honestly, I think it could actually be possible, because this art style might actually allow them to have things that are destructible. But I'm curious to know if it's actually something that's going to be scripted for like a building to fall in a certain way, or if it's actually going to be anything that's destructible, like wherever like a bomb hits, that part of the building will fall down. But either way, I think it's still pretty cool if that's going to get added. They actually did drop a Trailio? How the hell do you say that? But anyways, they're showing off a bunch of games, but for now we're only looking at Warfare 1944. They have a bunch of completed things here, but the one thing that I wanted to look at here was just the stuff that wasn't completed yet. We've got the United States Navy U.S. Aaron Ward. I'm assuming these are ships that are going to be used in Utah Beach. Although the one thing that I kind of find puzzling is the submarine here. Like, are we going to be able to use submarines? I wish they would have put a description here explaining what these are going to be used for, because it looks like they're actually going full on. They also have what looks like a aircraft carrier, which I also heard that you're going to be able to use airplanes in this game. It's going to be interesting to see. And then they show off the Willy Jeep, but this one has a 30 cal attached to it, it looks like, along with the Kubel wagon, which also looks like it has a MG42 attached to it. And then we get onto the vehicles that we haven't seen yet. We've got a Oval Blitz vehicle, which doesn't look too bad. And then we got a Chevrolet G506. So an American transport and a German transport. Pretty good, pretty good. I mean, you know, they don't really need to make it look that good, but yeah. They show off a T-17 armored car. I thought this was a British vehicle, but it says United States, so I'm assuming that's supposed to be for the US. Curious. And then we got a Wehrmacht Scharrier Panzerwagen. I'm sorry, I'm not good with the names here, but I think this is supposed to be a Puma. Kind of looks like a Puma, but I'm not sure. The gun seems a bit off to me. I think the gun's supposed to be a lot longer. And then we got the Panzer IV medium tank for the Germans here. I wonder how many people you can actually fit inside of it, or if it's just like a 1 to 2 man crew. They don't put a description here explaining that. And then they got the M4A3 E8 Sherman, which is the EZ8, I believe, my favorite tank in World War II. Can't wait to try that out. We got the Jeep without the gun and the Kubel wagon without the gun. And then it shows off the map, which is already in the game itself, but they plan to expand the map and make it look more expansive with a shit ton more objectives, which makes me question how long these matches are supposed to be. So you look at all these objectives. This is like ridiculous. It's a ridiculous objective map. This is what they've completed, just that part, but they want to expand it all the way out here. This map is going to be massive, massive. And I wonder how long these matches are supposed to last anyway, or if it's just like a day and night sort of thing, kind of like how Planetside is. But yeah, let's move on to the next one here. We also got Carentan again, and this is what it looks like. This is what it looks like, but it doesn't have this much of territory for us to grab onto. And then we look at the more expanded version. I showed this earlier, but there's a picture of Carentan right here, just like a shot of it. I hope you're gonna be able to like build stuff inside of these building areas, because that'd be kind of cool. This is what the map looks like right now. I think it's like the biggest map of the two, and they're going to expand it out even further as soon as they add in, you know, more stuff. So I definitely can't wait to see all that. So yeah, that seems to be all there is in terms of content for the Trailo. It's not very expansive, but then again, I think the game isn't really supposed to be that big when it comes to certain mechanics. Like, I think the core mechanics are already here. But yeah, that is that. They also got a roadmap here of things to come, so let's take a quick look at that. So here is the development timeline. I believe we are currently in the pre-alpha phase. They launched a Patreon and an itch.io, which I don't know what that is, but we'll look at the Patreon later. I'm assuming itch.io is just a way to donate to the game, maybe. Then they got game options, menus, and key management, which I'm assuming that's where I got mine. 64 player support, advanced and game secure game mode, persistent equipment kits, proximity voice communications, deployable respawn radios, medical kits, ammunition, explosives, moving into the alpha, launch on Steam early access, suppression mechanics, leaning, prone, and vaulting, being my favorites. Weapon bipod and resting, squad voice communications, base building and logistics, ground vehicles, tanks and artillery, single player and multiplayer bots, modding support, beta, integrated anti-cheat, procedural destruction. Oh, so they are gonna add that. Cool. Pilotable naval vessels, including capital ships. So wait, you're gonna be able to move that stuff around the big giant ships? How the hell is that gonna work? How big of a body of water are we gonna see here? Pilotable aircraft, 100 player support, release, launch on Steam, post-launch support, new factions, new maps, and new weapons. Neat. So let's take a look at the Patreon here. The Patreon is essentially here to support not only Warfare 1944, but development for every game. And it looks like only there's $5 a month, 15. We got quite a bit of stuff here if you want to take a look. 30 gives you a lot, but it seems like they already have about 300 patrons. So, I mean, that's pretty good. And they're getting about that much every month. And yeah, that seems to be everything with Warfare 1944. If you guys want me to cover his other games, then let me know down below. But until then, if you like the fact that I cover games like Warfare 1944, then go ahead and like the video, comment down below, and share. If you're someone that's brand new to the channel, subscribe and ding the bell. You never know, you might find something that you like on the channel that I cover. If you're someone that would like to support the channel, check out my Patreon. Just send $2 a month, it really helps. And with that all being said, I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.